Hi friends, this is Dr. Apoor Mehra, and today we are going to discuss at Conceptual Orthopedics about orthopedics, the beginning of the journey. A student is often confused how to approach the first year residency and then how to make a heart in the department, how to live in that heart in the department, and maybe develop a special corner. Student is confused about how to please the seniors, what all work to do. Suddenly coming from the cloud nine of topping an entrance exam, he falls at the bottom into a department filled up with lots of geniuses. Such a humble but strong background belongs to Dr. Vibhor, doing his MBBS from the prestigious Maulana Azad Medical College. You only live a dream when you end up getting an MS orthopedic seat. If not, but absolutely the best college for doing orthopedics in the nation. He is trying to enter a league which belongs to very few, but with these opportunities, his life, I'm sure, will be filled up with lots of responsibilities. His family, his loved ones have expectation that Vibhor will come out as a brilliant orthopedician. His juniors will be watching him. But most importantly, he himself has to answer himself at the end of the day how he will build up what once he thought of, his dream that belongs only to him. Yes, Vibhor. Why ortho? Sir. And you are a premium subscriber of Conceptual Orthopedics. Why Conceptual Ortho?
Sir, when I was in my internship, so during my ortho internship, it was my SR and my PG took me to the emergency OT. So they were putting an external fixator there and they let me assist. Sir, it was during at that point of time when I learned that this is something I enjoy doing, and after that day, sir, I was like, if I'm ever going to do something in my life, this would be it. Sir, that was the day that I thought that I will take this branch and this is something I'll enjoy doing.
So as they classically say, love what you want to do. Do what you really love. And you never work your day, because love is one emotion. If it is tied to anything in life, everything else becomes effortless. He set his passion right on the pitch. He had entered an operation theater, saw the core of ortho, and decided that this is what he will live for. And this is what he will die with. Right, Vibhor?
Yes.
Why conceptual ortho?
Sir, when I saw that you have produced an app for PG course, PG orthopedics course, and sir, I saw you, and sir, I saw Dhal sir in the faculty. Sir, I'm from done my UG from MAMC. So, sir, just to see you there and Dhal sir was like, I was satisfied that this would be something that would be useful for me. And to sir have everything on one app was like, sir, I just had to subscribe to it then.
Right.
There was no second thoughts.
Right. When I talk about knee replacements, it's a skill that you acquire with practice. But when you want to talk about computer navigation knee replacement, you want to link up the technology with surgeries. And when you want to take both together, I was classically taught in Germany that if you really want to learn computer navigation knee replacement, learn right from the beginning. because a good start is half done. If you have good start to a 100 meter race, if you edge even by a millisecond, that's huge. And this is what Vibhor said. I wanted to be sure that I get my knowledge from the right hands, from the right brains, and from a ladder which has been climbed by different people across the nation, and they are all on one platform. And this is the dream I had when I was developing conceptual orthopedics mentally, practically, on the paper, on the computer, on the app. As you will realize, any orthopedic residency, when you begin with, is training yourself on two things. As Professor Tully will always tell you, it's all about the mind game. A calm mind is capable to handle any storm. And if your focus is there in training your own self, your body, when you classically say, if you want to run a marathon, you just don't run on it for 42 kilometers in the one go. You prepare yourself over the time. And that is what residency is about, developing a mental balance and also developing the temperament, and your body should have the endurance to work for really long hours, because it is just 3 years. It is just 3 years consisting of 1095 days. But these 1095 days will decide the destiny of next 15,000 days. I will explain. 50% of your life is your career, and 50% is your own personal life. These 3 years, give it to your career. That 50% of personal life has 15,000 days. And trust me on one aspect. If these 1095 days are not valued, that 50% is only 50%. You will never be able to get more than 50. They are two different compartments, and you have to score in each of them. That is why be careful about the source that you choose, because they classically say, if you want to be the best, make sure you learn just from the best. Because if you give up everything that comes in the path of your target, you end up hitting the target. So the distractions have to get away. Stay calm. Don't get hyper when you enter. It's not something which is a 100 meter race. It's a marathon. You have to live with it for long. Keep your head down. These 1,000 days, keep your head down and study every day. Make the days count. That is what that matter. Each day, learn something new. Because the tagline is, the learning never ends. And one thing, work. You are fortunate that in the world where people don't have work, you have enough. So you have to live with a pleasure. Don't live with an agony. So Vibhor.
Sir, as a first year resident, sir, how should we look at getting opportunities in OT and what to learn there?
Right. So he has asked a lot of questions in one go. As a first year resident, what should be my approach and how to go in the OT? Number one thing. If you are a resident of orthopedics, be it diploma, be it MS or be it DNB, you are entering a beautiful branch which has a surgical aspect and clinical aspect, the OPD. Rarely you have this combination. So congratulations and celebrate. Don't forget, in the long run, life is about celebration. It's about enjoyment, right? People, just because they want to achieve too much, are decreasing their joy. and increasing their stress. Minimum stress is always required to perform, but excess of everything is only poison. Right? What you have to understand is, you give an exam for 3 hours, you get a rank and you get a seat and you enter there. And then it's a tag that you're doing orthopedics from this place. And there's a comparison in the world. This is a good college, average college, not so good college. But if you summarize, we have a platform which is going to get everybody at par. All the good teachers are together. They're all working to develop the best content and almost an error-free conceptual learning. So this is a ladder where you have juniors, intermediate segment, and to the top, from 35 to 50 years of experience all going together. So each time you come to the app, see what should we do in the basics. More importantly, see what you should not be doing. Because there's a beautiful book called as What Not to Do in Orthopedics. If you master that, you're always good. It's not about when to operate. It is about learning before when not to operate. And this you have to learn right from the beginning. And this is going to place everybody at one level. Just not on the basis of the college, but way beyond. You can think about just how the teachers teach in different colleges, different states, different languages. But one thing is there. All will refer to the standard guidelines. We are dividing your studies into different parts. Initially, they will push you into a ward where you will have to do dressings. See that the x-rays are done and see the x-rays. All there will be splints and tractions. So a first year will spend a lot of time in the wards. I remember when I was a first year, we had 24 hours duty and then off. Even in my post duty off, I used to again go to the ward. And I always used to see what's happening there. I saw that each patient who entered a college is a learning opportunity. Because I was very sure that I have to extract the maximum out of this. It's just like a sugarcane juice. You put a sugarcane in the machine, some juice will come out. Then you will again put it, more will come out. Then you again put it, more will come out. We see this. That's how the residency is. Each patient is your biggest book. Keep seeing it. Keep seeing it. You will have more and more findings. The next patient, the previous patient, is a comparison strata. Be courteous. Never ever scold anybody. People are watching you. These patients in the future will refer you patients. And the image that you develop in your wards, you will live with it forever. When you will move out, how you touch their life, they will remember. And two books that you should remember before for your wards is Stewards and Chanley. These two books, Chanley's will tell you the close treatment of fractures, and Steward will tell you about the splints and tractions. They are the Bibles of the wards of the first year. Then you will go to emergencies and OPD. This is an area of performance. Suddenly a patient will rush to you. Make sure you know the guidelines. Because your split second will save a life, or otherwise it will go against. Read these guidelines. See your senior teachers, your seniors, your SRs doing the clinical test so that you can diagnose. Next morning after the duty, you have to present. Sometimes in the OPD, you will present. Make sure these two books are with you. As thus, rarely we recommend Indian authors, but this Indian author book, brilliant. McCree's. They will tell you basic clinical examination. The advantage of McCree's, it has lots of images. Read this book in the first year. Your 30 to 40% of clinical practice and 80% of emergency will be trauma. Cowell's handbook should be with you for fractures. See a fracture, decide which classification it belongs to, go home or next day, before you sleep, read the treatment options. Operation theater. The question that you ask me, what should I do in OT?
Yes, sir.
If you actually ask, people will say, will I get a chance to go in the OT in the beginning? No. But as you get a chance, it's an area to observe. I think this will teach you discipline. The discipline of clinical practice, the discipline of how you will be learning to respect your seniors, the discipline of handling the soft tissues, the discipline of caring the bone. They say that orthopedicians are glorified carpenters, but they are way beyond. They are going to teach you the soft tissue handling, which is like the clothes of a human body. And if you don't handle it, you're sitting naked. That is why right in the first year, learn the correct things. And we are making sure in the app that you have a grasp of what actually is soft tissue handling. I have seen in my career great surgeons. I have seen legends. And I have seen average surgeons. And I have seen only one line that differentiates everybody. How clear and how meticulous they are about what they are going to operate and how planned they are. These are the books which will build up your orthopedic career. Applace for your basics. Campbell's is going to take you to the operation theater. Rockwood Greens about trauma. And Professor Thuli's tuberculosis book, if you are in India. Remember, Hoppenfield surgical book for the approaches should be always there, a copy in the operation theater. Before you see a surgery, read the steps. After you come out, revise the steps. It is a continuous process. Professor S.M. Thuli, at the age of 88, he studies every day. So never ask yourself how much more. You are entering a beautiful league of orthopedicians. Be responsible for it. Remember, we as human beings have a tendency that as we enter Vibhor into a college, we decide that this person is good, he is better, he is the best. But trust me, there is no bar. Everybody who's senior to you, even by one day, has lived a life for 24 hours more, will teach you. Don't judge people. Don't judge their knowledge. Take the best out of them and move ahead in this journey. That's all. Be selfish. You have to learn. So be humble, because that defines you. And then, we are developing a section in the app for you that's called as Essentials Vibhor, which will tell you how to apply a plaster, how to give a traction, what not to do in the cast, when not to apply a cast, how to wear the gloves, how to scrub, how to pain drain, how to start this journey. So this Essentials will take care of what you need to know. And obviously, clinical skills have to be harnessed right in the beginning. So like you just saw an interaction with Professor Dhal, we'll be having live sessions. So share, Vibhor, what did you feel during that live session of Professor Dhal?
Sir, it just felt like it was a one-on-one session. Or sir, it was like just I was in the ward and a case was going on. So it felt like I'm learning in the ward. Sir, and that was like the most important thing that I could get from that. And it was it felt one-on-one, because Dhal sir was showing you the sign, then he was asking you, and then he was teaching and he was telling you what more could be seen, what is the correct way. Sir, that is the thing that I felt.
And that too on a virtual platform. Feeling that you are bedside is something that these teachers can create. So, wishing you all the best, Vibhor.
Thank you, sir.
I hope that you have a splendid career, and thank you very much for taking out your time. Thank you.